Hello, everyone of this Potterbrony, and welcome to another blind reaction of some MLP Equestria Girls minis, mini shorts, mini series. These are more of the choose your own ending stuff. I kind of wish they hadn't done this, but what are you going to do? It looks to be entertaining, as always. So, this time I'm going to have five of them. It's going to be this number 2 through 6. I have Fluttershy's Butterflies, Text Support, Stressed in Show, Driving Miss Shimmer, and Rarity Investigates the Case of the Bedazzled Boot. So, those sound interesting, and each of them have 3 choices, but unfortunately, just to give you fair warning, the videos that I have, each of the 3 choices came with the actual minute or so leading up to it, so there's going to be a lot of repeat here. So just bear with that. I might just take that time as it's playing to, after the first one, to see and to talk about what I thought of that choice. Now, starting off with Fluttershy's Butterflies, the choices at the end of which are going to be Rainbow Dash, Applejack, and Vinyl, or DJ Pwn 3. So, yeah, looking forward to seeing where they go from here, what they have in store. Right now, these are on the Discovery Go app, or Discovery app, and actually, I don't know, because the first one that I reacted to was taken off YouTube, so I think this is just Discovery, just the app itself. Yeah, all right. Well, let's just get the first one started, see what Fluttershy's Butterflies have in store for us. And starting the video in 3, 2, 1, and go. Equestria Girls. Now, each of these I just put into one section, like the 3 choices I put into one video, edited together before watching this, without watching the actual stuff.
I can't believe we're doing Dazzled this year.
Nothing holds a candle to the glamour of legitimate theater.
Okay, so it's a... Alright, so... Selfie Fluttershy's got butterflies because she's trying to... She's in the play.
Of a dancer.
Let's all do the
makes sense.
Together. It'll be like planning an amazing party where everything has to be perfect or we get embarrassed in front of the whole school. Right, Fluttershy?
And she's gone.
I'm Fluttershy, trying out for coal miner number 2. Ahem. Down here, we mine for coal.
You okay, Fluttershy?
Oh, it would be so fun to be in the play with all of you. But when I think about trying out on stage all alone... Mm-mm.
You perform all the time with the Rainbooms.
What's different when we're all together? It's less... terrifying.
You that know, makes sense. When you got your friends'
just
support.
Just the trick for stage fright.
I bet I could help too.
Alright, so these are the choices. She's gonna be,
Really?
Choosing who could help her out. First is...
You just need a little practice speaking in front
Rainbow
of
Rainbow Dash.
Ready? You'll thank me later. Game on!
There goes, number 22 with the score time. Running, goes up and boom goes a header ball. Headball.
Lose yourself in the game. Come on, Fluttershy.
Number 22 is pushing to the limit. The ball, it's tucked away by number 34, who passes back to Dash. She holds it, makes her move. She's cutting, here's the cross. She's wide open. I don't believe it. Down here, we mine for
coal. And the crowd goes wild.
Not bad advice. All right.
E-H-X.
Oh, yeah. All the this stuff is going to be after every video, isn't it? And into the next one. All right. That was pretty interesting.
Auditions for the fall
no,
play.
Not really.
I can't believe we're doing this.
Yeah, game. Just force her into it.
Nothing
get her out there, and all of a sudden, she's over her problems.
I was born for the lead.
I liked it. It was cute.
Sophie Soot, a coal miner's daughter with the heart of a dancer.
Let's all do the play together. It'll be like planning an amazing party where everything has to be perfect, or we get embarrassed in front of the whole school. Right, Fluttershy?
All right.
Fluttershy, trying out for coal miner number two. Ahem. Down here, we mine for coal.
Yeah.
You okay, Fluttershy?
Oh, it would be so fun to be in the play with all of you. But when I think about trying out on stage all alone... Mm-mm.
You perform all the time with the Rainbooms.
What's different when we're all together? It's less... terrifying.
You know, I got just the trick for stage fright.
I bet I can help too. In half the time as
ever. And here we go with Applejacks.
It ain't a contest. But if it were, I'd win.
Really? Hmm.
Surefire's cure for stage fright is to picture everyone in the audience as a bunch of chickens.
Chickens?
A little cluck cluck
not
and
naked.
It'll pluck you right up. You never heard of this trick?
Mm-mm.
Everyone does it. And I mean everyone.
Well, if you picture everyone as animals, that would definitely help Fluttershy.
Told ya. Picture everyone in the audience as a bunch of chickens.
Let's see how this looks. Are we going to get a view into her mind's eye?
Trying out for coal miner number two. Down here, we mine for coal.
No, didn't get to see what she saw.
Chicken trick worked, huh?
Actually, I pictured everyone in the audience as you, Applejack.
Oh.
We believe you, Applejack.
Do you have to change your other friends into her?
Well, I'm glad you were
because they're just as supportive.
Because my backup plan wasn't so hot.
You're putting actual chickens in the audience?
I should probably get them back to the farm.
Yep. Nothing said. Not a word. That's unfortunate. Alright, so. Next we have DJ Pwn 3. I have to bear this for one more time. This is going to become painful.
Auditions for the fall.
Thankfully, it's not that long of an intro, and I mean, I tried to edit it out, but when I did this the other day with editing together and cutting out the little snippets of
let's all do the play together.
The intro and outro
like
of
an amazing party where everything has to be perfect.
I don't know, my editing software isn't the best,
right,
so when I was editing out the intro and outro of the Dragon Ball Z or best list from Team 4 Star of the Dragon Ball games, I noticed a little bit of like the audio of the next section started before the video, like in the video, the first froze for a couple, for like a second.
When I think about trying out on
if I'm going to try to splice it with mine, then...
You perform all the time with the Rainbooms.
What's different when we're all together?
It probably end up doing the same, because like I said, my editing software is not the best thing in the world.
Just the trick for stage
but that's what you get for using free stuff.
In half the time as Applejack. It ain't a contest.
And there's, Vinyl.
But if it were,
I didn't notice her before.
Really?
Now, what advice could she give? Yeah, screw you two. I'm going to her for help. I see this, I think of coal mining, yes. It's cool, though.
Down here we mine for coal.
to make an entrance.
Yeah, you two got upstaged. That's interesting. She didn't actually go out on stage. Loophole. All right. LHX. So yeah, that was Fluttershy's Butterflies. Interesting stuff. Just the different choices and everything that that's there. Yeah. Now, we have, what is it? Text support, which will have choices of Rarity, Fluttershy, and Sunset Shimmer. So, let's see what this one has in store for us. And, starting the video. In 3, 2, 1, and go. Equestria Girls.
How cool is chemistry class? I can't believe I got to come up with my very own chemical formula. Jalapeno Supernova Cupcake Frosting!
Yeah, sounds awesome. Assignment.
Aw, you sound just like my lab partners. Couldn't have done it without you guys! I just got the weirdest text from Timber Spruce.
Pirate, plane, alligator, thumbs up, waterfall, golf club, ice cream sundae.
What does it mean? Is it an inside joke? A hieroglyphic reference? A secret code?
Yeah, it would confuse you, wouldn't it?
My brain feels weird.
Confuse the hell out of me.
Not knowing things.
Sounds like you could use a translator.
I could help.
Leave this one to me.
Who can get me out of this textastrophe?
As you are no doubt keenly aware, I am fluent in all the latest text slang. Phone lingo.
So going with Verity.
If I may.
Oh, so you're just gonna...
No, darling.
Thank you so much. But what did I just say? Oh, he replied.
Not really helping much.
Robot shooting star trophy? Oh, he's a witty one.
He won a space robot contest.
Fancy You're... dress anvil high five.
Verity, what the hell are you doing? You're not anvil? Telling her what he's saying.
Oh, no, shh, Donnie.
Or what you're saying to him.
Do you like ice cream?
Who doesn't like ice cream?
Check mark. Couple holding hands, sunshine, three balloons, spoon.
I'm sorry, but what just happened?
Oh, well, I started by sending a dragon because you're powerful. Ice cube and snail because you're cool, but take it slow. And then pyramid, well, for obvious reasons. And he was way into it, so in this last one I was just double checking. You and Timber Spruce have a date on Sunday at 3 o'clock to have ice cream.
Thumbs up, smiley face.
You're welcome.
Yeah, use words, please. All right, the next one is going to be Fluttershy.
LHX.
Hopefully we'll be a bit more helpful. Although she did explain what it was at the end. Yeah, but that would annoy the hell out of me if it was done to me. Like that.
How cool is chemistry class? I can't believe I got to come up with my very own
chemical formula. Blah, 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 blah.
Jalapeno Supernova Cupcake Frosting!
Sounds delicious. Again.
Aw, you sound just like my lab partners. Couldn't have done it without you guys! I just got the weirdest text from Timber Spruce.
Pirate, plane, alligator, thumbs up, waterfall, golf club, ice cream sundae.
What does it mean? Is it an inside joke? A hieroglyphic reference? A secret code? Ugh, my brain feels weird. I'm not used to not knowing things.
Sounds like you could use a translator.
I could help.
Leave this one to me.
Who can get me out of this textastrophe. So, what are you thinking,
Fluttershy? And Fluttershy.
I'd start with a bird.
Sounds good.
Then, iguana, guinea pig, regular pig, frog, baby chick ever the egg, all three seen no evil monkeys, cat, 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 all the cats, and,
all the cats, yes.
Finish it with a squirrel on his hind legs.
Sounds good. Scent, that was perfect. So what did I say? Send?
A bunch of cute animal emojis.
But what does it mean? He says yes to the zoo! The zoo? Oh, the zoo! Thank you, Fluttershy!
No matter what the problem is, adorable animals are always the answer.
That one's cute, too. Alright. I'm liking the new outfits, though, for these characters. Seeing them more...
E-H-X.
Like with, Fluttershy looks adorable as always. Alright.
How cool is chemistry class? I can't believe I got to come up with my very own chemical formula. Jalapeno supernova cupcake frosting!
That wasn't the assignment.
So just like my lab partners.
Just like my lab partners.
Yep.
Couldn't have done it without you guys! I just got the weirdest text from Timber Spruce.
Pirate, plane, alligator, thumbs up, waterfall, golf club, ice cream sundae.
What does it mean?
What does that one mean? Nobody explained that one yet.
Hieroglyphic reference? A secret code? My brain feels weird. I'm not used to not knowing things.
Sounds like you could use a translator.
Stressful for her.
I could help.
Leave this one to me.
Yes, let's leave it to Sunset
this
time.
Catastrophe! Timber Spruce wants to dress up like pirates and fly through waterfalls with an alligator while we eat ice cream with golf clubs for spoons? That's crazy! Golf clubs would make terrible spoons.
Have you thought about maybe asking him what he means?
Ooh, great idea. How would I ask that in emojis? Calling? No calling! Who talks on the phone? Sunset, what?
Hey, Timber Spruce. Sunset Shimmer here. That text you sent, Twilight Sparkle. Oh, that's what you meant.
Yeah, I'm with Sunset 100% on this.
You just boy talked. Mouth words. Phone.
He's wondering if you're free to play pirate alligator mini golf this weekend.
Oh, duh, of course. How do I say yes? Oh. Yes.
Yeah. And I rarely use emojis at all. Never in texting, and never
E-H-X.
Exclusively text and emojis. That's just way too freaking much. In fact, up until I got an actual smartphone that had but that was mainly just for convenience. Before I had a phone that had a full QWERTY keypad in it, before I got the iPhone, if somebody texted me on my old phone, I would just call them back to answer because I'm like, I am not punching through try not to curse with MLP stuff, but yeah, I would just call them back and be like, yeah, I'm not going through all that to text. Need to press 1-3 times for C and then for space. It's just, no. You young kids don't remember that crap, do you? But yeah, now I'll answer back, but it's never with emojis. Just, you know, full-on sentences, not even shortened stuff. It was like my friends were like, why are you typing everything out like that? It's like, why aren't you? But yeah, totally on Sunset's side on that one. She's cool. Alright, so that was text support. And now we move on to stressed in show. With choices of Fluttershy, Rainbow Dash, and Pinkie Pie. And starting the video in 3, 2, 1, and go. Equestria girls.
Mother, I fear I do not share your dreams of color. Instead, my heartbeat calls for me to dance.
Painful.
Heartbeat calls for me to dance. To dance!
Reminds me of Redneck Rarity.
But selfie soot, my sweet summer child, without your help,
I know it's a play this time, though.
The mine in time.
Oh, the mining.
Mine the flash century in time, or help Applejack build the stage in time, or practice my monologue in time, or find time for time in time.
He's getting stressed out because of the show.
Am I missing a page?
When was the last time you took a break from the play?
Take a break. Break a leg. Break a take. I think she's broken.
Breathe, Twilight. You just need something to take your mind off the play a little while. We're here for you, right, everyone?
Of course.
Let one of us help you take your mind off it.
You bet.
Go with Fluttershy. Yes.
Ta-da!
Skunks. No.
An escape to nature. Oh dear. I got mud on my boots.
Didn't Twilight get, skunked in an episode?
Design selfie, so it's magic.
Something about wrapping up winter?
Oh, no. Don't think about that. Think about this.
Yeah, those are different boots.
As you can possibly be.
That's a tall order from that little bastard.
Aw, he's adorable.
It's why
of course, this angel
so much more than big cities.
Was never as bad as the other one.
Applejack is building the city sets while we're out here lost in the woods.
Animals unite! Dazzle her with your tranquility.
Dazzled is the name of the play.
So you can order them around? Summon them, not just talk to them?
Oh, yeah.
No, that would be painful.
This is nice. So relaxing. So calm. So...
Let her take a little nap, everyone. All we need now is some volunteers to keep her warm. Spunky and Plunky, are you up to the task?
Well, I guess, you know, if they're not spraying you, it's not bad, but... I would think they would have some type of residual odor to them. Alright, so that was with Fluttershy, then it's Rainbow Dash, and then Pinkie Pie. Yes, because go to Pinkie Pie to help relax. That makes so much sense. Alright, and more pain, pain, pain.
Instead, my heartbeat calls for me to dance. Heartbeat calls for me to dance. To dance!
Oh, sorry, But selfie soot, my sweet summer child, without your help, I'll never mind the mine in time. Or run lines with flash century in time, or help Applejack build the stage in time, or practice my monologue in time, or find time for time in time! am I missing a page?
No, it's all there, you just can't read, Rainbow.
When was the last time you took a break from the play?
Take a break, break a leg, break a take? I think she's broken.
Breathe, Twilight. You just need something to take your mind off the play a little while. We're here for you, right, everyone?
Of course!
Let one of us help you take your mind off it.
You bet! Come on, Twilight! Only
yeah, exercise the stress out of her. That makes sense.
I'm fasting as lap as I can. A great practice always clears my head. I promise, you'll feel great in no time.
You're overusing again.
We'll catch up.
No spike talking. I guess they didn't get Kathy West like for these, huh? Yeah.
Hi-ya!
Rocky reference there.
Look at that! You beat me, and I only sort of let you win.
I feel completely de-stressed, and we managed to give Spike some exercise. And I guess Sunset, too.
Wow. Yeah. And yeah, I know Sunset never struck me as the athletic type, but I think she'd be able to keep up with Twilight if they were all doing the same thing. I didn't know Twilight was training, but whatever. Stressed in show again.
Mother, I fear I do not share your dreams of hope. Instead, my heartbeat calls for me.
Rolling eyes at Rarity. Just shake my head here in this voice.
To dance!
Oh, sorry.
Not her normal voice, mind
but
you.
But selfie soot, my sweet summer child.
She's not this annoying normally. It's just
mine in time.
I know it's just playing, but blah, 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 whatever.
Or help Apple Jack build the stage in time, or practice my monologue in time, or find time for time in time!
Am I missing a page?
When was the last time you took a break from the play?
Take a break? Break a leg! Break a take?
I think she's broken.
Breathe, Twilight. You just need something to take your mind off the play a little while. We're here for you, right, everyone?
Of course.
Let one of us help you take your mind off it.
Yeah, let's see what Pinkie Pie does. I'm sure it'll work out, but
I know what we could do to get your mind off the play. We could ask Rarity for a makeover. Oh, or ask Bulk Biceps for a massage. He gives such good massages. Or we could ask Applejack to whip you up an apple face mask. Ah, there's so many options. Maybe too many options. It's kind of stressful just thinking about it, right? Huh? Where'd you go? Twilight! There you are. I've been looking all over for you.
Yeah, this is about as I thought how it would go.
I made an anti-stress list. You love lists, don't you? Well, to start, this is a list of lists we can make. We can make lists about color, lists about numbers, lists about buckets, lists.
Twilight? Make a bucket list.
Twilight!
You walked away from a list, Twilight? Come on. You're better than that. Yeah, we didn't see that coming.
You be here? Pinky, listen. I really appreciate what you're trying to do and everything, but it's too much. All day, all I've been able to think about is where's Pinkie Pie? Where's Pinkie Pie?
But you're not thinking about the play, are you?
One moment, too. Think about the play.
That smug look on her face.
You're welcome!
Not exactly relaxing, but she did accomplish what she wanted to in getting her to not think about the play. So, that was Stress in Show, with Fluttershy, Rainbow Dash, and Pinkie Pie as the choices. Yeah, interesting. This whole thing with having, just sitting through it, I'm not going to edit them out, but obviously, you might be skipping around people watching. That's fine with me. Probably should have mentioned that earlier. It's like, yeah, go ahead and just fast forward. You don't have to sit through me sitting through that again. Alright, next we have Driving Miss Shimmer. And this one will be starring Sunset Shimmer, of course. As one would expect. Hang on a second. Sorry about that. Speaking of texts earlier, we're losing my train of thought. On to the next one, Driving Miss Shimmer. So I guess Morgan Freeman's going to be driving her around? That'd be pretty cool. Alright, lame attempt at a joke. And watching the video in 3, 2, 1, and go. Equestria Girls. Oh, driving test. Okay.
You failed.
Mr. Cranky Doodle said I didn't have enough experience to pass the driving test. I have a retest on Monday, but it's my last chance, and he wants me to practice with someone more experienced.
Oh, darling, is that all? I can take you anytime you like. Don't fret your fridge.
Right. I can borrow this one, obviously, you're going to be Rarity, Applejack, or Fluttershy.
Well, I guess I'll go.
You guys got
with...
cars? Rarity first. Because this is how Rarity drives around, yes.
Isn't it fabulous? I rented it for the day. If you're going to study driving, you must do it in style. I call it stretch chic.
So not the point.
No, just a few things that you absolutely must know. Always have both sparkling and still water. You never know which one your passengers will prefer. Never play the music too loud or too soft. It has to be just enough that the heads bob, but not so much.
This is advice for limo drivers.
Finally, always have your lights on the ready in case of an impromptu party breaking out.
Your headlights? Rarity, I'm not going to prom.
Look.
I'm just trying to pass my driving test.
How about you both? Just a little bit. Oh, no, an inch to the left. Now, careful.
Are you trying to parallel park a stretch limo?
Ooh, driving can be stressful, darling.
Not bad, Sunset. You completed the left turn, the right turn, the U-turn, and the K-turn. But now comes the part where everyone fails. Parallel parking. Don't expect
not
to...
if you have a car to, do it for you.
Where on earth did you learn to do that?
I just had to stretch my talents.
Well, if you can parallel park with a stretch limo. Actually useful advice. Alright. Moving on to the next bit. Where I assume she's gonna learn to drive a pickup or something. I'm looking forward to seeing Fluttershy's.
What do you mean you failed?
Car. What kind of car does Fluttershy have?
Mr. Cranky. Save the best for last, huh? I didn't have enough experience to pass the driving test. I have a retest on Monday, but it's my last chance.
At least in this one.
He wants me to practice with someone more experienced.
Oh, darling, is that all? I can take you anytime you like.
Don't fret your fritters. I can borrow Granny's truck.
We could use my car.
Well, I guess I'll go with...
Granny's truck.
Thanks for helping me out, Applejack.
Think nothing of it.
Which is...
I've been looking for a reason to take a spin in the old jalopy.
Who are you calling a jalopy?
Clean out your ears.
See? Like she's fresh off the lot.
I can't believe
are
she's still in
offended
good
that she's
condition.
Calling the car, the truck a jalopy.
She's something, all right.
You girls ready for the ride of your lives? Now, the first thing you ought to know is...
Don't run over nails.
Be
yes.
prepared.
To fail?
To change a tire.
Or anything.
All right, Sunset. Use that wrench to loosen the bolts, and we'll get this tire replaced in two shakes of an apple tree.
And what if I don't have you and Granny Smith around?
Well...
Use the jack.
Oh, this is unfortunate. Of course, I know how to change a tire, but I wouldn't want you waiting.
And it actually
so I guess,
comes in useful.
You fail? Is that fair?
Not to worry. I know exactly what we need.
You do?
An Applejack.
I don't remember that. That was kind of painful, but first, just get down to that fun. I don't remember having to change a tire with my driving test. Just the normal driving around, stopping, how many lengths of car in front or behind, parking techniques, all that stuff, but... Alright, now on to Fluttershy.
What do you mean you failed?
Mr. Cranky Doodle said I didn't have enough experience to pass the driving test.
They're not calling him Cranky Donkey.
On Monday, but
Cranky Doodle
last chance.
I guess his last name in this world is Doodle.
He wants me to practice with someone more experienced.
Oh, darling, isn't
that wrong? Then he should be used to people calling him Mr. Doodle.
You like.
Don't fret your fritters. I can borrow Granny's truck.
We could use my car.
Well, I guess I'll go with...
the best one, yes.
Sunset, over here.
Tiny little car.
Sweet
that
ride, Fluttershy.
In you go, Miss Kitty.
All right, I'm ready to clock some miles on this bad boy. Let's do this.
It's the driving safety run. Start your trip with seatbelt time. 9 and 3 is where you'll be. Adjust your mirror to see things clearer. Check your little engine light to make sure that the trip's all right. The coolest drivers will admire...
All right!
...properly inflated tires.
So, what are we learning first? Turns, switching lanes, parking...
And 9 and 2?
Funny you should
ask. 9 and 3, that's
awkward. I actually have a rhyme for that, too.
Now, Sunset, I know all this safety business might seem boring to you, and it is, but it's also important. Tell me, what do you do even before you start the car?
Turn up the radio. Oh, not that. It's the driving safety rhyme. Start your trip with seatbelt time. 9 and 3 is where you'll be. Adjust
That's 10 and 2, which is
clear.
Very nice.
I just kind of go 10.
If you're driving's as good as your rhymin's, I'm sure you'll do just fine.
Yeah.
I had some help from the best. Now it's time to pass this test.
Just start the car.
Yeah, I'm with you there. All right, well, that was cute, as they all are. 9 and 2, that just seems awkward to hold the 9 and 3. I don't know. At exactly opposite sides of it? No. It's just one hand on 12. All right, so that was Driving Miss Shimmer. And next we have Rarity Investigates the Case of the Bedazzled Boot with Pinkie Pie, Trixie, and Applejack. Now, this one I'm expecting a lot of noir. And let's just see what has in store for us. If it's anything similar to the episode named Rarity Investigates. Which is one of the best Rarity episodes. Alright. Let's get this one started in 3, 2, 1, and go. Yeah, noir style.
I tell ya, no coal mining daughter of ours is going to Shiny City wearing boots like those.
Cut!
Snips, snails, where's the other boot?
Hey, props ain't our job.
Yes, it is. Your job is props.
Well, yes, but...
Call him out on that.
The play is about magic dancing boots. No one's buying tickets to see a magic dancing boot.
Somebody's pilfered my bedazzled boot,
and she has to investigate.
But a new case falling right into my lap.
So is that prop or costume?
Don't you worry your sweet redhead. Redhead. Speaking as the lead
redhead
whose foot
looks great
doors,
to me,
and the costume designer whose mind dreamt of it in the first place, let me assure you, I shall find the boot. But where to begin? Somebody's got to know something.
I hadn't noticed before, but somebody
what
pointed
you
out.
Say, Miss
Carly,
if that's your real name. I can't take it anymore. It was me.
She ate all the pancakes. Good Rarity.
It couldn't have? You were nowhere near the auditorium when it went missing.
I wasn't.
You were at the frozen yogurt shop.
I was? You literally still have frozen yogurt in your hand.
Huh. Where did that come from?
You were just so upset I thought confessing would make you feel better.
I could tell that dame had a sweet tooth. But trouble, there's still something you are not telling me. You saw something.
Like
I was saying,
I took more than one free sample, and then I put the
talk about that in the
wrong
cup.
Slow down, and then someone took my spoon.
This is bigger than spoons.
And I watched them, Rarity. I watched them eat my yoga germs!
Pinkie Pie, please! Have you or have you not seen my boot?
What about a boot?
The one under the pile of bell bottoms? You solved the mystery! But I have so much more to confess. Solving a case never tasted so good.
Okay, I noticed somebody talking about Flash Sentry's hair. People tell me about it in comments. Someone, I'd have to look it up, but someone said something about Vegeta suing him, so he had to change his hairstyle due to lawsuits. I thought that was pretty cool.
I tell ya, no coal mining daughter of ours is going to Shiny City wearing boots like those.
Cut! Snips, Snails, where's the other boot?
Hey!
Alright, so with this one, we're gonna have...
Yes, it is.
Trixie.
Your job is props.
Well, yes, but... Right.
The play is about magic dancing boots. No one's buying tickets to see a magic dancing boot, huh?
Somebody's pilfered my bedazzled boot, eh?
Yeah, now I'm just looking it up.
But a new case falling right into my lap. Not bad. Don't you worry your sweet redhead. Redhead? Speaking as the lead whose foot that boot adorns, and the costume designer whose mind dreamt of it in the first place, let me assure you, I shall find the boot. But where to begin? Somebody's got to know something.
Found the comment. I'll read that later.
The moment she strutted into my office, I already knew she was guilty. Only guilty people strut like that. That's a guilty person's strut.
The moment I strutted into her office, I knew I could outsmart this buffoon.
The dame wasn't talking, and that was fine. I cannot talk, too. I cannot talk for hours. I'm not
you guys are
right
gonna
now.
Get far this way.
Me neither. Looks like Trixie picked up a racket and decided to play.
Little does she know, two can play this game.
Oh, there for a long time.
But I had a little special something prepared.
Makeup? We could be here.
For hours. You win.
I always like that effect with those.
But the match.
Like with Sin City and that type, just a little bit of color. Type of. Dwarf stuff.
You better clean up these rocks. Someone could get hurt. Not me. But you know, someone.
It's the poop.
Spike?
Sorry.
Oh, I guess they did get Kathy.
To be a dancer.
You want to dance in the play? Oh, we'll find a spot for you, Spike. But next time you borrow a boot, ask first. Case closed.
Trixie, amazing.
How come nobody's talking out loud?
That's not how these things work, Spike. But apparently you all can hear each other. Alright, yeah. Comment from MLP FIM Brony 2232. I guess that lawsuit from Vegeta for copying his haircut finally caught up to Flash.
I tell ya, no coal mining daughter of ours is going to Shiny City wearing boots like those.
Cut! Snips, Snails, where's the other boot?
Hey! Props ain't our job.
Yes, it is. Your job is props.
Well, yes, but... Right.
The play is about magic dancing boots. No one's buying tickets to see a magic dancing boot, huh?
Somebody.
Yep. And
boot, eh?
What will.
But a new case falling right into my lap.
Applejack. Not that have magic. To do with it.
Don't you worry your sweet redhead. Redhead? Speaking as the lead whose foot that boot adorns, and the costume designer whose mind dreamt of it in the first place, let me assure you, I shall find the boot. But where to begin? Somebody's got to know something.
Well.
Last time I saw them together was when I was building the mineshaft set over by the costume rack.
Detectives trust their instincts, and mine were telling me to check the costume rack.
Good outfit.
All the people, Maud! Honestly, I never pegged
you. Good to see you, Maud.
Crook. Who put you up to it? What do you got against my big debut?
Sinisterly stroking the boot.
Why?
Because they didn't get.
You might have thought this one is rose quartz, but it's actually amethyst.
Nobody thought that.
They're just rhinestones, darling.
Made of amethyst. The world's largest amethyst geode weighs 2.5 tons.
A 2.5 ton bedazzled gem? Oh, now you're.
Are you imagining yourself holding it?
Yeah.
Me too.
Geodes over me.
I thought those types of rocks were snooty.
Oh, nice.
Good to see Maud. And that makes it the best one, because Maud was in it. Alright, so that was Fluttershy's Butterflies, text support, stressed in show, driving the shimmer, and Rarity investigates the case of the bedazzled boot. I hope we can get more Maud in future episodes. Maybe have her be one of the choices. I know there are 5 more, which I'm not going to be doing in this video. This video is already over 45 minutes long. So yeah. Hopefully you enjoyed that. Show your support. Go to the Discovery Go app. Check it out over there. Hopefully check it out before here and choose your own ending. I mean, I watched all of them, but have fun with that. So yeah, I want to thank you all for watching, and I'm gonna end this one here. Until next time, take care. Bye.